Hello friends and welcome to our tutorial. Today we'll be talking about stretch typography. This is a very cool effect which reimagines classic animation techniques such as squash and stretch and smearing. So, without further ado, let's jump into the tutorial. Okay, so first things first, and before we begin to work on the project, I want to talk about typefaces. The typeface itself plays a huge role in this method and has to be carefully selected. It has to be geometric with rectangular elements. I've chosen the Space Grotesque typeface, as it suits our purposes just right. It's rounded, but it has some rectangular elements, which will stretch very good. The typeface is free and you can download it at Google Fonts to follow me along. Alright, we'll begin our work in Adobe Illustrator, and I've already prepared some text, and next thing I wanna do is to create some reference states for my animation. Let's think of this as the initial state and the end state of the animation. I already prepared some guide images, so I'll stick with them, and you can follow me along or create your own. So, the initial state will be like this, will look like this. And the end state will look like this. So, what do you want to keep in mind if you wish to create something your own? Not all letters will look good while stretched. So, the golden rule here is to pick some letters that have rectangular elements. And in my case, these will be letters R, O, P, I, G, and E. So, let's begin preparing our text. Let's select our text, right click on it and create outlines. Ungroup it. I'm gonna bring in my reference image and I'll start to move my characters. Now what I want to do, I want to split this character in half and ungroup it as well. Now I'm gonna draw two rectangles to kind of weld my character. Now let's select these shapes and unite them. Cool. Now for the line number 2, I'm gonna align my letters or characters. If you wish to call them like this, I'm gonna stretch out the letter P and I'm just gonna duplicate the letter O. Okay. I'm gonna stretch the letter I like this. Now for the third line. Okay. Alright, so the letter G is a little bit tricky because it has extreme points which are located in, they are not on the same axis. So keep in mind that the splitting has to be in the most extreme points. So maybe even here. In the most extreme points at the top and at the bottom. Okay, so I'm gonna select everything and split it as well. Ungroup everything. And reposition it. And I'm also gonna draw a few rectangles to unite my shapes. I'm gonna select everything. And unite it. Okay, So, this is my initial state. Now what I want to do, I'm gonna select everything, copy it, create a new document. I'm gonna call this 1, Full HD. Press OK and hit Command F to position the characters in the same place on the artboard. Okay, now I'm gonna check if everything is ungrouped. Yep, that's good. Now in the layers menu, I'm gonna select my layer and I'm gonna click on this little icon here and select Release to Layers Sequence. And now Illustrator has separated all of my characters into separate layers. Next thing I want to do, I want to rename everything to keep my project tidy and clean, and I also want to have the right order of the layers. So as you can see, this letter O, it should be in here. So I'm gonna take some time and do it. Okay, cool. Now that I have my layers prepared, let's go to the After Effects and begin our animation. So what I want to do is I want to import my file. I'm going to drag it into the project window and I'm going to import it as composition, footage dimensions, layer size. Now the next thing I want to do, I want to select all my layers, right click on one of them, create shapes from vector layer. Now After Effects has created some shapes from my vectors. You can delete them since we don't need them anymore. And here are our shapes. I'm gonna also delete the layers. Okay, so now let's begin to animate. First thing I want to do, I'm going to label my layers. Now I'm going to shy the middle line and the third line, hide it, and shy it out. All right. So, as I mentioned earlier, I already have some reference states for my animation. Since I've made this one, this is the initial state, I'm going to need only the end state. I'm going to import it into After Effects and place it on the timeline below my text. And now, let's start animating. Also, what I want to do, I'm going to lock my reference image. Okay. Now let's begin. Let's select our letter O. Open its contents. Go to path 1 and path 2. And in the beginning of the composition, let's create some keyframes. Now, on the first second, I'm going to select these points and move them here like this. Next is letter R, the same here. I need to select my paths, go to the beginning of the composition, create some keyframes, and on the first second, select only these points and move them in here. Now what I want to do, I'm going to copy paste my initial keyframes. So we'll have a nice loop. Cool. Let's go to the line 2. And animate it as well. So. Let's begin with this letter. Create some keyframes. Right here. Copy paste the initial keyframe. Now for the letter N. Letter N is actually doesn't stretch, but it moves. So I'm going to animate its position. Letter B, though, stretches and moves, so I'm going to animate its paths and its position. Actually, no, only the paths. Copy-paste keyframes as well. This is letter R, which moves and stretches. Sorry, guys. Okay. So. Let's stretch it like this. You know what? I don't think I need to animate the position because the path animation works really well. So, it's more than enough. Okay, and now for the final letter in this line. Let's select its paths, create some keyframes, go to the first segment, select only these points, and move them like so. And now I'm gonna copy and paste my initial keyframes. Okay, so the second line is ready. Now let's do the same for the third line. Okay, so here the letter R might probably move and stretch. I don't know if it's true, but it's possible. So we'll see. Actually, yeah. Be careful to select all the points. Yeah. The path animation is more than enough. Now letter E. And copy and paste my initial keyframe. So I've got this animation now. I'm gonna hide my reference layer. Okay, but if we will play this down, we'll see that the animation is pretty dull and numb because we didn't do the easing for the keyframes. And I also forgot to animate the asterisk. Okay, so for the asterisk, there will be a rotation animation. I'm going to rotate it 45 degrees on the per second, and I'm going to rotate it to 90 degrees in the end of my animation, so it will look like this. Okay, cool. Now what I want to do, I'm going to select all of my shapes and change their colors. Yeah, really nice. And you know what? I think I'm going to offset this animation of the middle line. The end state will be the initial state, and the initial state will be the end state, just so we will have a bit more interesting animation and our shapes will be moving in different directions. Alright, now I'm going to select my shapes, hit U to bring up all the keyframes. I'm going to select all my keyframes, go to graph editor and hit F9 to easy ease all of my keyframes. I have a rotation too. Okay, just going to check everything. Okay, so now I've eased my keyframes, but the next thing I want to do, I want to make the easing as much dramatic as possible. So basically I'm gonna pull the handles till the extreme, so we will be having very slow motion, and right about the 15th frame the speed will ramp up, and then gradually the animation will slow really gradually. Okay, so the next thing I'm gonna do this for the first part of keyframes and for the second part of keyframes. Okay, cool, so we're basically done here, and let's see what we've got. Alright guys, and the last thing I want to do, I'm going to animate the color of my asterisk. And to do this, I need to bring up its fill. In the beginning of the composition, I'm going to create a keyframe. On the first second, I'm going to change the color and just copy paste the first keyframe. And easy ease everything to align nicely with the already made animation. Alright, cool. Let's see what we've got. Yep, nice. Okay, and the last thing what I wanna do, I'm going to create some nice little background. Alright. Bring it to the back. Pretty cool. Okay friends, that's it for today's tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it. Please hit like and subscribe to our channel, and if you have any questions, don't hesitate to ask them in the comments below. Thank you again for watching, and see you in the next videos.